We established that passive house starts with the envelope, so let's get into implementing envelope details. The first thing for optimizing passive house is minimizing the losses of the envelope. We increase the insulation level and get airtight, continuously insulated, and thermal bridge-free construction. Thermal bridge is an interruption in the envelope that allows heat to transfer through it. For example, a steel beam that goes from the inside through the wall to the outside. The wall is insulated, but the beam is like a conductor that transfers the moisture because of the temperature differences. You can recognize a thermal bridge because of the condensation, the bubbles on the paint. Thermal bridges are problems because of two main reasons. First, the condensation and the mold, which is an important factor in creating a healthy environment in the building. And second, because of the energy losses. In a standard building, there are only a small percentage of the total energy losses, but in passive house, there are up to 10 or 15%. So they make a big difference in the durability and energy balance. The next step is optimizing and balancing the gains and losses with high-performance glazing, proper shading, passive ventilation, and calculating interior gains. Also, using efficient systems like heat and fresh air recovery, high-performance mechanical equipment, and highly efficient electrical systems.